MI4C is the better version of MI4i, which was launched in India. MI4C packs in some amazing specs for the price tag of $250. So should you import MI4C because it is only available in China as of now? So should you import or should you not? Or should you consider the phones that are available in your country for the same price? Let's find out in this full review of MI4C. My name is Saurabh Nahar and you're watching All About Technologies. Let's begin. MI4C is made out of plastic, but in no ways it feels cheap. It feels really well built, and also it feels really compact due to the 5-inch screen size of the display. Now talking about the physical aspects, MI4C comes with a USB Type-C port and quick charge support, which makes this device future-proof. The buttons are placed on the right side of the device and they feel really clicky, and you should not have any problems with that. Output via the speaker is not very loud, and overall the speaker is average in terms of quality and loudness. Although the output via the headphone jack on headphones and earphones is pretty good, and you'll enjoy listening music via earphones and headphones. Now, unlike MI4i, MI4C also comes with an IR blaster so that you can control all your electronics and gadgets with this device. This device also comes with dual SIM support, and this device supports 4G on both SIM cards, so that is really nice. Now talking about the display, MI4C comes with a 5-inch Full HD IPS display, and this is one of the best IPS displays that you can get in this price range. The outdoor visibility on this display is also quite good, and also the viewing angles are quite good on this display. MI4C comes with a 3080mAh capacity battery, which is non-user removable. Now talking about the battery life on this device, it is above average. You can easily get through a day without any issues. You'll get screen on time varying between 3.5 hours to 4 hours. So overall, the battery performance on this device is above average. I won't say that it is the best, but yes, definitely it is above average. So as we all know, MI4i comes with a Snapdragon 615 processor, which is very well known for the overheating issues. And there was a lot of overheating issues with the MI4i when it was launched. And that is the reason MI decided not to make the same mistake with the MI4C. And hence they have included the Snapdragon 888 processor, which is a hexa-core processor with 3GB of RAM. So there is no overheating issues with the MI4C, and as well as the performance is really good with the MI4C. Now in my day-to-day usage, opening up applications, multitasking and switching between applications was not an issue on the MI4C. Even playing graphic intensive games like GTA San Andreas, Modern Combat 5, Asphalt 8, all on the high graphic settings were working just fine on this device. So overall, I was quite impressed with the performance of the MI4C.
Now getting into the software side of things, MI4C runs on MIUI 7, which is built on top of Android 5.1 Lollipop. And in the past, I have used a lot of MI devices or Xiaomi devices, but MIUI 7 feels much more faster, and it is also very much faster in terms of opening up applications and switching between applications. So overall, MIUI is quite smooth and quite fast on the MI4C. Now you also have a lot of cool features with the MIUI, like double tap to wake the display, and that will turn on the display. If you go into the settings, you also have an option to manage notifications on per application basis. So for example, if you don't want any notifications from game like Asphalt 8 and other applications where developer sends you some notification and you don't want to get disturbed because of that, you can do that. You can also turn off the sound and vibration for a particular application, and you can also turn off the notification light if you don't want for a particular application. So that is really a nice feature that is given on the MIUI 7. And you also can change the wallpapers and themes and icons and a lot of things. You can totally customize the look of the MIUI 7 on the MI4C, which is really simple. They have a dedicated store from which you can download tons and tons of wallpapers, themes and icons and a lot of stuff. So that will overall customize the look of the phone, and that will make your phone stand out from the crowd. Now you also have something called edge control, which I have never seen on any other device, and that is really a unique feature to MI4C. So if you double tap on the side of the phone, it will take you back to the previous application or the previous page that you were using, or even to the home screen. So for example, if I open gallery application now, and if I double tap on the side, it will take me back to the home. So that is really a nice feature and a cool feature that I have never seen in the past. And you can also click pictures by simply tapping once while using the camera application. You can see the demo here. So that is really a nice and cool feature and unique feature to the MI4C. Now if we talk about the camera, the 13 megapixel camera on the MI4C can take some amazing pictures. And I have taken a lot of pictures indoors and outdoors, and even in low lighting conditions, and all the pictures look quite amazing and quite detailed and sharp. So you won't have any complaints with the pictures that were taken with the Mi4C. And even the pictures that were taken in HDR mode were quite good. Although the HDR could have been slightly better, but nevertheless, it does a good job. And I'm totally impressed by the pictures that were taken with the Mi4C. But I won't say that for the video section, because in video section, the autofocus is not all that impressive. It is pretty decent. You have to manually tap to focus. So that is a issue. But overall, the quality is quite good for the 1080p. And you don't really have OIS on this camera. So that is how it is. And also you can't shoot 4K. So these are the 2-3 things that you have to remember in terms of the rear camera on the Mi 4C. And if you talk about the front facing camera performs really well. You can take some amazing selfies with this front facing camera. The selfies look quite good even in the low light conditions, and I am completely happy with the front facing camera of the Mi 4C.
Well, Mi 4C packs in a lot for the price tag of $250. Although one thing which is missing over here is expansion with SD card. So you can't expand storage, and it is only limited to 16GB or 32GB variant depending on which variant you pick up. So definitely I'll leave all the links in the description if you want to pick up these devices, because this device is really good for the price tag if you don't mind paying something extra like import duty and shipping charges apart from $250 price tag. So yes, definitely Mi4C is a great pick for this price. And hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button down below. Hit that subscribe button if you want to see more such videos in the future. I will be coming up with a lot of reviews, unboxing and other videos on other devices. So make sure you subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Instagram, Snapchat. All the links will be in the description down below. This is Saurabh Nahar here from All About Technologies. Thank you guys for watching.